It's firm, it's green, and it will save the day with how delicious it is. Kalpat is made from tapioca and rice flour. All your kids will rave over it because they get to play with the slime and also eat it. The earthy aroma of pandan with fresh coconut shreds will surely soothe your sweet tooth. Make sure to plan ahead as it takes a while to cool. It will be worth the wait. Sabaidi Pinong, hi fam, welcome back to Sang's Kitchen. Summer is slowly approaching, so I thought what better dessert to make than something that's chewy, cold, refreshing, and it's gonna be this Lao traditional dessert called Kalpat, pandan rice cake. I highly encourage you to invite any kids around you to come and make it with you because they're gonna love it. It'll probably remind them of that slime they like to make. This also requires patience, so go ahead and start early. It's gonna take about 3 hours, so let's get cooking. The first thing you want to do is prepare the coconut meat. So go ahead and grab the coconut and then a hammer, and you're going to be very careful, and then you hit the coconut in a circle until you see it crack. Once it cracks, you're going to start seeing water gush out, and you want to save that to drink for later. And then once you're able to fully crack the coconut, go ahead and peel it right open. And then I'm going to use this fancy coconut tool and shred my coconut meat. You can use whatever you have. If you have a fork, go ahead and shred it with a fork. You want to shred as much of the coconut meat as possible, and then you're just going to put it to the side. You have two options, young coconut or mature coconut. So young coconut is really good because it has refreshing water and has a little bit of meat, but it's really soft, versus mature coconut has sweeter water and its coconut meat is much more thick and hard. So pick the right coconut that you enjoy. The second thing you want to do is prepare your fresh pandan water. So I have frozen pandan leaves that I'm going to chop up, and then I'm going to put water in my food processor and then the chopped up pandan leaves, and go ahead and process that for a couple minutes until everything is finally chopped up and you see that all the water is green. After that, you can go ahead and put it through a sieve, and then you're going to see all the nice green water come out, and then the fibers of the pandan should stay in your sieve, and you're going to toss that. In a separate bowl, you're going to add the coconut water, the pandan water that you just made, and then some extra pandan flavoring, and then lastly the sugar, and then you're going to whisk this all together until the sugar is well dissolved and everything's mixed well. In another bowl, go ahead and add the rice flour, the tapioca flour, a little bit of salt, and then you want to whisk this together until it's well incorporated, and then put it to the side. I encourage you to play around with the rice and tapioca ratio. Note that adding more rice is going to make it more soft, and now adding more tapioca is going to make it more chewy. And also, if you want it less sweet, go ahead and add less sugar. So you can see that this dessert, you can customize it to your liking. In a large saucepan, go ahead and add your rice flour mixture, and then right on top you can add your coconut milk mixture. And you want to whisk this all together until everything's well incorporated. After that, go ahead and turn your oven on high until everything starts to boil and you see that it becomes this slimy, gooey mixture. At this point, you can go ahead and turn it on low, and then you're going to continuously mix on low for about 8 to 10 minutes until everything's well cooked, and you should see that it becomes this shiny, shimmering slime mixture. After that, I'm gonna go ahead and turn it off. I'm gonna spray my pan with some cooking oil so it doesn't stick, and then you want to carefully take that really hot goo mixture and go ahead and slowly pour it right into your pan, and then to even it out, go ahead and spread the top until everything is an even layer. And now this is where you have to practice patience. You're gonna let it sit outside for 1 hour until it cools down. After that 1 hour, you can go ahead and put it in the fridge, and it's gonna take another 2 hours to fully solidify and set, and then we'll come back and check out what has happened to our dessert. Baking in Lao cuisine didn't really exist, so the majority of desserts were either made by steaming or boiling, like this dessert. So I encourage you to be creative because there are a lot of Lao desserts that are made by boiling or steaming. So this also just shows you that you don't need an oven to make delicious desserts. Okay, it's been 3 hours, our dessert is set, so I'm gonna take it out, go ahead and put it on a cutting board. You want a really sharp knife, and you're gonna make clean cuts, and then I'm gonna make these into diamonds, so I'm gonna cut diagonal. And you can see how delicate these are, so you can pick one up and just take a look at it. It looks so good. It's almost like a jello texture, but more sturdy. With this kalpat, I'm gonna plate it in a coconut shell, so I'm gonna first do one layer of kalpat, and then with the coconut shreds that we made earlier, I'm gonna put one layer on top, and then I'm gonna continue this until I fill up all that coconut with kalpat. And that's how you make kalpat. I'm gonna come right up there and show you how delicious this is. Here it is, y'all, kalpat. Oh my gosh, it looks so good. I'm ready to dig in. I'm gonna take this big chunk on top with all that fresh coconut meat on top.
That's really good.
Kalpat is perfect after dinner. It has that really nice jello texture while giving you that extra crunch from the coconut meat. It just melts in your mouth. I'm probably gonna eat this whole thing. I hope you try making this traditional Lao dessert. Kalpat is a great dessert for any beginners in the kitchen. And also, if you have extra, go ahead and put it in the fridge and it should last for about a week. And let me know in the comments below what Lao desserts you've tried making, and I'll see you all next time on Seng's Kitchen. Bye.